La música de Harry Fry.
What's going on, Kevin Burke? And I'm joined by Kemba Walker. Kemba, how you doing this evening?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
Not bad. Are you still on cloud nine for the national championship at UConn? Have you come back down to earth so far?
Man, I don't think I'll ever in my life come back down from that cloud. No, just an amazing run, you know, for me and my teammates. And you know, I just had a blast throughout that whole run. So, you know, I'm going to be on the high for a long time.
Even before the NCAA tournament, of course, you had the Big East tournament. Five games, five nights, unprecedented. What was it about you? What was it that gave you guys the will and determination to play five and five games?
We just wanted to win. You know, that was it. You know, a lot of those games that we played in that tournament were revenge games. You know, we beat DePaul and Georgetown during the season, but we didn't. We lost to Pittsburgh, lost to Syracuse, we lost to Louisville in the regular season. So, you know, we just really wanted to beat those guys when it counted. And, you know, we did that.
Have you offered Gary McGee a formal apology yet from Pitt?
Man, that's old news, man. You know, Gary McGee is a good friend of mine, so, man, he was on the island. You know, I wanted to score. I wanted to win the game, man. I just had to do what I had to do.
Is that step back the go-to move?
I think it was last season. You know, I used it a lot last season. You know, I don't really use it a lot anymore. You know, I don't know. I haven't played in many games lately, so, but... Yeah, I guess you could say that.
What happened with you between your sophomore year and your junior year? You went from a very good player to a national player of the year contender. What happened in the offseason with you?
Well, you know, I just felt like I had so much to work on, you know, to become a great player. That's exactly what I did. You know, I got a chance to go to different camps, you know, learn from some guys, and, you know, I just became a different person, you know, a different type of animal, you know, in the offseason, you know. No, I'm not really a talkative guy, but you know, being that I was, you know, one of the guys that the freshmen were going to look up to, I had to, you know, be more of a vocal leader. So that was something that I had to work on, you know, just being more social around people. So you know, that was something that really helped us, you know, as a team.
Many people forget that, yeah, you played 3 years of college ball, but you graduated. Was that your plan heading in to do that, graduating 3 years?
No, not at all. No, I really wanted to just go to school for a year. Go to the NBA, but you know, didn't work out that way, of course. But you know, it was a great choice of me staying for 3 years. And you know, after my sophomore season, you know, it was just one day. I'm like, man, I know I can't play basketball for the rest of my life. So, you know, I just wanted to get school over with. You know, honestly. So that's what I did.
Be honest with me now. It's just me and you, right? Nobody else is listening. Do you think you should have been player of the year?
Nah, I think Jimmer really deserved that award. You know, a lot of people are gonna say that I'm just being political, but you know, honestly, I'm not. I was playing great. He was playing great. Then, you know, at one point, you know, I slumped. You know, I had a string about, you know, maybe four or five, you know, six bad games. And you know, while I was playing bad, Jimmer was playing great. So, you know, the award is about the regular season. So, you know, I think he definitely deserved it.
Number 9 overall pick to the Bobcats. On draft night, you went up and you shook David Stern's hand, and then you walked down, I believe it was Stuart Scott, to interview you right after. And you said, you know what, I'm not 6'5", 6'6", but you know what, I got a big heart. Why did you say that, and who were you talking to?
Man, he asked me a question. You know, everybody always has a question about my height, you know, whether I can do this, whether I can do that. But you know, like I said, you can't measure heart. You know, I'm a tough player, you know, I go out, give it my all every night, and, you know, try my best to win basketball games, and, you know, you can't beat that.
And finally, obviously, Michael Jordan is the owner of the Bobcats. Have you had a chance to speak to him yet? Let me save you from yourself, I mean, before the lockout. I don't get you in trouble.
No, definitely not. Well, I spoke to him a few times before the lockout, but, you know, that was about it, and it wasn't really, like, deep conversations. You know, we just had, you know, probably 2-3 minute talks, and he was just telling me how excited he was, you know, to be working with me and Bismack. So that was really it.
What can Bobcat fans expect from you next year?
Expect from me? I think they can, you know, expect, you know, just I think the Cats fans can expect growth. You know, that's really all I could say. And I don't want to say, you know, wins or anything like that, but I definitely can say that we will, get better, as a team.